just because I'm kind of a little bit short on time, y'all are coming to a really cool area. We've got Jose Clemente here with me. He's intercultural relations. We're the ones that are your indoctrination into the country of Spain. Not into the commands, but into Spain itself. You're coming into a really cool area. We got the third largest cathedral in the world. Columbus is in there, DNA proven. We've got Gibraltar, 100 miles away. You can cross over and go see a little bit of Great Britain over there. Portugal, 3 hours away. There's a lot of travel. There's a lot of things to do. Columbus, in the castle that was up there earlier, that castle, Columbus was there. He passed through that area whenever he was coming over here to find the Americas. There's so much to do up there. Amusement parks, snow skiing. We got snow skiing, the southernmost snow ski resort in Europe. Got 106 kilometers of ski trails. It's huge. We've got boat fishing, anything and everything you want. Mountain biking, hiking, mountain climbing, you name it. There's a lot of stuff to do there. And the cultural side over there is incredible. We're going to assist you with that. We're going to help you out with the language pieces, help you out with figuring out the money. We're going to teach you to speak a little bit of survival Spanish, so it'll get you off to a good start. So that you go into the restaurants, you know how to order things like that. Spain's different, but it's a good different. Everybody over there is very excited about everybody coming into the community. They're waiting for you. We've got plenty of housing. Everything is going to be available for you. The experts are here. Any questions you've got about anything, come by and ask us. Come by and speak with us. The experts are here. If we don't have that answer, we'll get it for you. Come and see us. Come and talk to us. Good to go? Our next speaker. Security at the border. All right. Where we're at? You see where it says Cadiz down here in the bottom? We're at the frontera. We're just above Cadiz. That little hip right there, right above Cadiz. You can look over into Cadiz, oldest city in Europe. It's right across the bay from us. Oh, I got 10 minutes? Let me introduce you to Mr. Jose Clemente. He is our intercultural relations. I thought I only had about 2 minutes. I got 10, so we're good. I'm going to bring Clemente up here. Clemente has been working with the base, been working with us at Fleet Family Support Center with intercultural relations for over 30 years. If that's not resident expert for, you know, where we're at and getting involved in the community, I don't know what else is.
Muchas gracias, John. Can you hear me without the microphone? Can you in the back?
No.
Then I need a microphone, right? Better now? So, my name is Clemente. I've been with you for the last 30 years. My career on base began before you were born, some of you, right? It was a very long process. So, I'm trying to tell you how wonderful my country is. And if you have any doubt, again, we are out there for your question, but don't hesitate. If I were you, I would go to Spain. Because look at it from that point of view. It's a kind of paid vacation for you. Of course, you have to work, right? Because working for us is a different philosophy. Working for us in Spain, in my country, is like a divine punishment. So I've been trying to tell you this for the last 50 years, right? Well, I mean, in my case, for the last 30, but you do not never pay attention. All right, because you know you're going to work early in the morning about 7, 7:30. You never know you're going back home about 3:30, 4, 5, 6 p.m., and that's terrible. Because there is no time for you to have fun with your family. Yes, in case you have children, relatives are too much involved doing working there. And then I would like you, once you are there, pay attention to the Spanish Navy personnel. In winter time, they start working at 8 a.m. But hardly you will see them at 8. It's way too early. 8:30 probably is the time. And you'll find how at 3 p.m. they are done. All right, but 3 p.m. over there, the only one that will remain over there is the guy who is stupid. About 2. Summertime is too hot. You are going to be in the south of the country. All right, like in the south of the Spain. You saw the temperature that we have today in Norfolk? During the month of July, August, that's the temperature up there. It doesn't invite you to work. So they know that. So about 2 p.m., they are ready to go back home. All right, when you look at the map, can you please, well, I have the clicker here. I don't know how this clicker is crazy. And the clicker that we have, the clicker that we have, the African Family Support Center, chief, where is he? He called by himself. Doesn't pay attention. When you look at the map of the Iberian Peninsula, you look at it and say, that's a big country, right? It looked big there in the map. But this place, the entire picture is smaller than Texas. So if you are driving 12 hours in Texas, where did you go? Didn't know anywhere, right? You're still there. But if you are driving for 12 hours from this place, which is in Rota, you are going to be in France. 12-hour drive. I do not recommend you to go to France, because you got to see Spain first. The French people, I hope you do not have family in France, right? Because the French people are not very friendly. So, and the enemy is there. That we are totally surrounded by enemies. So, we have the Portuguese, we have the enemies, because Portugal was part of Spain too. Then we have the North Africa that was Spain back in the 60s, last century, that was part of the country. And then we have the British, and the British are the worst. Do you know why? In history, because there is a place that is well known everywhere, it's here. That's the Strait of Gibraltar. And in there, the British had, what, Gibraltar, the rock, in Spanish soil. All right, that's for us like having something in our heart. But finally, MWR will take you to see Gibraltar. You can see the monkeys over there too that are unique in this country. So when you look at the map, look big, we have the mainland, this one, the capital of the country is Madrid. If you drive from Rota 6 hours,